The Audiotrix Pro, one of the only two sound cards released by Mediatrix, is quite difficult to find. Here we have a demonstration CD that was handed out, presumably at trade shows, in 1994 around the world. Let's listen to what the demo CD has to say.
Welcome to the world of Audiotrix Pro. The Audiotrix Pro brings sound quality to the PC that has never been experienced before. This revolutionary soundboard combines 24 voices of wavetable synthesis with 20 voices of FM synthesis to create a sound experience so rich and realistic that you'll think you're listening to a live performance. With a suggested retail price of $295 US, the Audiotrix Pro represents a new standard in affordable, high-quality PC sound. Everything that you are about to hear has been recorded using the Audiotrix Pro. All of the music, whether FM or general MIDI, and all of the digital audio, whether Sound Blaster or Windows Sound System, has been recorded directly from a PC using the Audiotrix Pro. Welcome to a new era in PC sound, the Audiotrix Pro. In the beginning, PC sound was available only from the internal speaker of the computer. One of the first companies to realize the potential impact of sound in PC games was Sierra Online, and in 1987, they introduced Leisure Suit Larry 1. About 1 year later, Adlib introduced an FM soundboard for the PC based on the Yamaha OPL2 chipset, and in turn, Sierra Online introduced Leisure Suit Larry 2, which had an FM soundtrack which was a great improvement over the music played through the internal speaker of the PC. Now in 1994, Mediatrix has introduced the Audiotrix Pro, a wavetable and FM soundboard based on the Yamaha OPL4 synthesizer, and Sierra Online has created Leisure Suit Larry 6, with Super VGA graphics and an orchestral quality general MIDI musical score that even gets Larry excited. However, music is not just about technology. Music creates and reinforces the atmosphere of a game. Music gives the game another dimension. Even FM music, with its synthetic texture, helped popularize games for the PC. Some FM music was outstanding. Listen to the following original FM compositions written by Michael Land for the LucasArts title, The Secret of Monkey Island. Or listen to the following exotic melodies and rhythms included in Inca, an epic adventure by Coattail Vision. Thank you. In spite of its contribution to PC gaming, FM music is no longer on the cutting edge. Wavetable technology and General MIDI have taken the quality of PC music one step further. The objective, however, still remains the same: the creation and the enhancement of the mood of the game. One of the very first games to use General MIDI music was Trilobites: The Seventh Guest. This game was produced only on CD-ROM and included an original musical score by the Fat Man. This adventure puzzle game is still one of the most popular PC games ever. Listen to the haunting opening theme as the guests enter the foyer of the mansion. And who could resist the beautiful apparition that beckons us to follow her down the dark, mysterious corridors of the mansion? Unfortunately, not all General MIDI music sounds the way that the composer intended. Since the design of each sound card is different, and since the design affects the playback performance of the card, what you hear may or may not be what the composer intended you to hear. The instrument volume levels, for example, may be out of balance. Recognizing this problem and not satisfied with the performance of most sound cards on the market, the Fat Man began a campaign to strengthen the General MIDI standard. His Fat Labs testing facility offers sound card developers a means of testing the General MIDI performance of their sound card. The AudioTrix Pro is the first sound card to be awarded the Fat Seal certification by Fat Labs. The Fat Seal means that General MIDI music played back on the AudioTrix Pro will sound as the composer intended it to sound. As an example, listen to some of the following General MIDI sequences composed by Robert Holmes of Sierra Online, which are excerpts from Gabriel Knight. This game takes place in New Orleans and involves mystery, religion, and intrigue, with a little Dixieland and voodoo thrown in for good measure. The game begins with a theme, progresses to the library, moves to the park, and goes on to the Voodoo Museum. Gabriel ends up with a visit to the cathedral. Even without any video, you will know exactly where you are. PC Sound, however, is not only about music. PC Sound also includes digital audio. In games, digital audio is used mostly for sound effects and voices. Shortly after AdLib introduced their FM soundboard, Creative Labs introduced the Sound Blaster. The original Sound Blaster included FM for music and one 8-bit digital channel for sound effects and voice. Listen to the combination of FM and 8-bit voice in LucasArts' Day of the Tentacle, played back through the Sound Blaster compatibility of the AudioTrix Pro.
I'm thirsty.
I don't think you should drink that. It looks bad for you.
Nonsense. It makes me feel great, smarter, more aggressive. I feel like I could. Like I could. Like I could.
As music technology evolved, so did the technology of digital audio. 8-bit soundboards were replaced by 16-bit soundboards with CD-quality digital audio that went up to 44.1 kHz for recording and playback. The AudioTrix Pro uses the CS4231 codec from Crystal Semiconductor to record and playback 16-bit digital audio. Listen to the clarity of the dialogue between the narrator, Larry Laffer, and Gammy Boisoulet from Sierra Online's title, Leisure Suit Larry 6, Shape Up or Slip Out.
The woman behind the front desk is a real knockout.
Good day, miss. My name is Larry. Larry Laffer? I'm here as a guest of Stallions, that famous television show.
How do you do, sir? I'm Gammy Boisoulet, Head of Human Services and Customer Relations here at La Castellata. My job is to make sure your visit here is everything your heart desires. And less.
I suppose we could begin by checking into my room. I do have a room, don't I?
Oh, but of course, Mr. Laffer. Stallions has taken care of everything for you.
LucasArts has also combined some great General MIDI music with terrific digital audio in their latest release, TIE Fighter. Listen to the opening music based on John Williams' original theme and the rumbling of the Star Destroyers as they fly straight at you, followed by dialogue between the Emperor and Darth Vader.
Empire is on the verge of success. Soon, peace and order will be restored throughout the galaxy. Even now, our capable forces, led by Darth Vader, are striking back at the rebel insurgents.
Prepared for our attack. Signal Vice Admiral Thrawn to launch his TIE squadrons immediately.
The AudioTrix Pro, however, is much more than a game card offering support for AdLib, Sound Blaster, Windows Sound System, and General MIDI sound standards. The AudioTrix Pro can be used as a legitimate music synthesizer. Listen to a General MIDI sequence created by Brian Havis using Cakewalk Professional for Windows and played back on the AudioTrix Pro. The music is taken from a composition by Jean-Michel Jarre entitled Magnetic Fields from his live concert in Houston.
Mm-hmm.
Several composers have written music specifically for the AudioTrix Pro. Listen to the following composition by Henri Chalifour, a well-known Quebec musician, called Fashion, which explores the great potential of the AudioTrix Pro. The AudioTrix Pro also benefits from an extended 44-voice polyphony, which combines 24 voices of wavetable synthesis with 20 voices of FM synthesis to create a sound palette unmatched by any other sound card. Listen to an original avant-garde composition by Gerard Jones, another well-known Quebec composer, entitled Technovox, which explores this 44-voice hybrid synthesis available only on the AudioTrix Pro. The AudioTrix Pro can also be used as a recording studio. Because of its ability to record 16-bit 48 kHz digital audio, its onboard ADPCM hardware compression, and its ability to function in full duplex mode, that is to play back and record WAV files at the same time, the AudioTrix Pro is great for multimedia presentations and other digital audio applications such as speech recognition and direct-to-disc recordings. As the first step in the creation of a multimedia introduction, listen to the following general MIDI file, What is Love, played back through the OPL4 synthesizer of the AudioTrix Pro. Now we are going to combine a voice track WAV file with this MIDI file using the full duplex features of the AudioTrix Pro. To do this, we will open up two media players in Windows and play back both the WAV file and the MIDI file at the same time. While doing this, we will simultaneously record the combined output into another WAV file in ADPCM format using the WAV recorder included with the AudioTrix Pro. Listen to the high-quality output which is possible with the AudioTrix Pro. This new file takes up only 25% of the space required by a regular PCM file with no perceptible loss of sound quality. Welcome to the world of AudioTrix Pro. The AudioTrix Pro brings sound quality to the PC that has never been experienced before. This revolutionary soundboard combines 24 voices of wavetable synthesis with 20 voices of FM synthesis to create a sound experience so rich and realistic that you'll think you're listening to a live performance. The AudioTrix Pro also offers some sophisticated expansion possibilities. A powerful DSP effects processor daughterboard is available that permits effects such as reverb, delay, flanging, panning, chorus, as well as a three-band equalizer and 3D sound positioning. These effects are fully programmable, and because of the presence of the DSP, they are also upgradable by software. The effects can be added to any musical composition, whether in general MIDI or in FM. The effects, incidentally, also work in DOS and with both general MIDI and FM music, so they can even be applied to the music of a game. Listen to the following general MIDI sequences. We will start out with no effects and slowly increase the reverb to the maximum using the fully programmable features of the DSP effects processor. Once at the maximum, we will shut off the effects and then put the reverb back on to an optimum level. This flexibility is also available with delay, flanging, chorus, and panning. We'll be right back. A sample RAM daughterboard is also available, which allows the addition of custom sounds to sounds in the ROM of the Yamaha OPL4. Listen to the comparison of the following two versions of the same composition played back by the Audio Tricks Pro. The first version is played back using only the sounds in the ROM chip of the OPL4. The second version is played back using the sounds in ROM as well as custom sounds for the strings which have been stored in the RAM daughterboard. This ability to use custom sounds gives the Audio Tricks Pro unlimited flexibility. Everything that you've just heard on this CD has been recorded using the Audio Tricks Pro. This exceptional soundboard is compatible with AdLib, Sound Blaster, Microsoft Windows Sound System, and General MIDI sound standards. It can operate under DOS, Windows, OS 2, Windows NT, Next Step, or even Linux. In fact, it is the most compatible soundboard on the market today. It can reproduce high-quality music from FM to wavetable and high-quality digital audio at 16-bit 48 kHz at a price almost everyone can afford. No wonder Ted Chapman of Computer Game Review said, and I quote, "Surprise, surprise, surprise. The Audio Tricks Pro came through the tests with flying colors, excelling in all areas and surpassing my wildest expectations. This card is nearly perfect." For more information on this amazing soundboard, please contact MediaTrix Peripherals. Welcome to a new era in PC sound, the Audio Tricks Pro. The following music was recorded using the Audio Tricks Pro. All of the sequences were composed by Tran Whitley of Tran Tracks and are taken straight from his general catalog. These sequences are written for live performances and contain all of the music of the original song except for the melody line. MediaTrix would like to thank Tran Whitley for his permission to use these sequences on this demo CD.
As always, thanks for watching the Soundcard Database, and see you next time.